Good morning, everyone. My name is Jack Martins. I welcome you to our meeting on Senate Standing Committee on Local Governments. With us this morning, we have Senator Ritchie. How are you? Senator Stewart Cousins. Good to see you. In addition to everyone here in the committee room, I'd like to welcome all of our viewers who are watching via telecast. I'd like to start today's meeting with our first bill. It's a bill that proposed by Senator Gallivan, S2787. Councilor Reed.
This is Bill 7, Senate Bill 2787 by Senator Gallivan. It's an act to amend the local finance law in relation to the sale of municipal obligations by the County of Erie. Specifically, this bill would amend the local finance law to permit Erie County to market serial bonds at private sale until June 30th, 2012. This is an extender for 1 year.
Any comments or questions?
Welcome.
Motion by Senator Stewart Cousins. Can I have a second? Second by Senator Ritchie. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed?
I-6.
I-6. Bill is reported. Our next bill is Senate 2976A by Senator Maziarz. Councilor Reed.
This is an act to amend the real property tax law in relation to tax lien transfers and to repeal Title IV of Article 9 of the real property tax law relating to the acceptance of taxes on certain loan corporations. Specifically, this bill would establish a new Title IV in the real property tax law to establish the authority to provide a tax lien transfer whereby a property owner can authorize a third party to pay the owner's taxes. Pursuant to this authorization, such payor would pay the tax collector, and the tax collector transfers the tax lien to the payor, and the owner repays the payor. Basically, this would be a system governed under the real property tax law, whereby you would have loans to be able to pay for your delinquent taxes.
Any comments, any questions?
I guess there's just a little bit of concern because that's like an 18% interest rate, right? The way
there's an 18% interest rate on the monies forward or advanced
that are borrowed. It seems a little high.
And there are fees associated with this.
Yeah, it seems a little bit high. I mean, if you're in trouble anyway, it doesn't seem to.
And it certainly begs the question if there are other methods available for someone to be able to pay those bills. But it is a form of relief in certain respects. On the other hand, we have received opposition from banks who are concerned about the fact that there will be a lien transfer that will have precedence over their own mortgage, which may create some issues. But from the standpoint of a homeowner.
No, I understand.
Well, maybe went through some difficult times, allowing them the opportunity to look for an alternative method that they might not otherwise have and get them through a rather rough point in their lives. I think that's the intent of this bill.
I know.
Although there may be some rough points here with respect to the amount of interest that may be charged, certainly I would think we could speak to the sponsor about those particular points.
For those reasons, you've articulated them so well, because, again, I know what the sponsor's intent is, and certainly we want to be able to help, distressed homeowners. I'm not sure that this will actually do that, so I'm with that right.
Very well. Can I get a motion to move it?
Yeah.
Motion by Senator Ritchie. I'll second it.
I-6 without recommendation, Senator Zuko.
And I'm voting
without recommendation. All right. Bill is reported. Our next bill is Senate Bill 2982 by Senator Stewart Cousins. Councilor Reed.
This is an act to amend the local finance law in relation to bonds and notes for the city of Yonkers. This is virtually identical to what we just did for Erie County, only this takes care of Yonkers. For Senator Stewart Cousins.
I think they've received the home rule.
Yeah, they did on March 2nd.
Yeah.
And again, it's an extender
for 1 year.
Can I get a motion? Motion by Senator Ritchie, second by Senator Stewart Cousins. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Aye, six.
Bill is reported. Next bill is Senate 3797 by Senator Oppenheimer.
This is an act to amend the general municipal law in relation to the establishment of the White Plains Industrial Development Agency. Specifically, this bill would add a new section 902B to the general municipal law to create a city of White Plains Industrial Development Agency. The operations of such IDA would be limited to the corporate limits of the city of White Plains, which is in Westchester County.
Any questions or comments? Got a motion to move it, can I have a second? Second by Senator Ritchie. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed?
Aye, six.
Bill is reported. Next bill is my bill, Senate 4047, Councilor Reed.
This is an act to repeal section 680F of the general municipal law relating to the Village of Westbury Community Development Agency. Specifically, this bill would dissolve such Westbury Community Agency, which is a public benefit corporation, which is no longer needed since the Nassau County Urban Consortium has undertaken the agency's responsibilities. This is a consolidation bill, and this bill is being done at the request of the Village of Westbury, which is in Nassau County.
Any comments or questions? We should have probably wrapped it back into...
I know, it's right, that's exactly right.
Second thought, but the village has asked us to dissolve it, so I think it's fairly straightforward. I have a motion to move it, can I have a second by Senator Ritchie? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Aye, six.
Bill is reported. Last bill is Senate 4285, Councilor Reed.
This is an act to amend the general municipal law in relation to authorized onsite inspections on housing in violation of zoning laws. Specifically, this bill would add a new section 99B to the general municipal law to authorize the onsite inspection of any rental property if such is advertised in excess of the zoning certificate of occupancy. More specifically, pursuant to this bill, a notice of violation would be issued to the owner, whereupon the owner would have at least 7 days to prove compliance or being subject to an on-site zoning inspection by a municipal housing inspector or tax assessor for the limited purpose of confirming compliance with the applicable zoning law, which the advertisement indicates they have violated.
Any comments or questions? Excellent. Can I get a motion to report it? We got a motion and a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Aye, six.
Bill is reported. Thank you very much for being here. Before you leave, please grab a cup of coffee.
Certainly will.
Let's